All right, making a little video of this trailer brake controller install. There's gonna be a lot of cuts, pauses, whatnot. I'm really just doing this for reference. Not sure if it'll work, but I'll try to make it decently short. All right, so I got a 2021 XL STX. 2.7 EcoBoost, and it's got, you know, a couple of those towing add-ons, but no towing package. Got the little coin tray here. So let's see what we got here. All right, so first part, this little module thing, and this should be all OEM, came from the dealership. $280 after taxes. So that'll go down there supposedly. I found a install guide from Ford. So I'll kind of loosely follow that. Not loosely, I'll follow that before we get into the craziness. All right, here's this bad boy. So supposedly we can just pull that little coin tray out, so let's see what happens. I think it should be finger tight, but I don't know. Might just pop it out real quick with that. Ooh, I don't know if that'll fit. Maybe get a little. There we go. Kind of work it out a little. Sweet. So we got a little cord here. I'm gonna pause it real quick. All right, and that just snapped in on the little coin thing. It was just a little placeholder. It just kind of came right out. Didn't really seem like it snapped in there. Video I'm looking at online shows plus and minus at the bottom. I'm gonna check the install instructions real quick. All right, yep, plus minus at the bottom, so this should just click right in. Beautiful, we're done. JK. All right, onto the module. I don't know if you can really see, yeah, you can see it decently, so it just kind of sits up there. Two wires, looks like a gray and a black. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull that out real quick. Looks like just the two bolts, 10 mil, holding it. All right, those two little bolts. This grommet was kind of messing with me, so I just kind of tore it off. All right, we'll switch these wires to over here and install this one. All right, we're all in. Go ahead and turn the truck on, see what happens. All right, no changes up here. Let's go in here and see if we got anything. Oh, come on now. Alright, so I don't see anything in there. Alright. Try see if we get any errors. No errors up here. I don't know all the settings. I don't know if there's trailer. Yeah, there is towing settings. Well, sweet. Looks like we're off to trying to flash this. Just wanted to call out, it said the trailer brake controller is number 42 in the fuses, so this 30 amp, just wanted to check, make sure it was installed on my truck, and it is. Alright, so we connected our OBDC or OBD connector. We have the software for it, and then we got 4scan. I just ordered this thing right here the other night. Went through those steps, downloaded 4scan. All right, so we're connected. Hit yes here. Found recorded profiles. Would you like to load the selected profile? Yeah, so I saved this loaded profile earlier. All right, so now we should be connected. I just watched a video. This guy, and just want to double check which screen he hit. I think it was this one. So the chip has like the modules. He went to IPC. What the hell? Did he double click it? I don't know if I want to hit that. Let's see what he did.
And this is going to give us access to all the modules here that we can modify. What we're going to go ahead and do is go do IPC configure model configuration. We're not going to go into the as-built format. That's where we're going to, you know, write codes to change things with the daytime running lights and the tailgate lights. Go ahead and select control configuration, and then we're going to hit play.
Yeah.
It's going to read the configuration. If your battery's a little low, it's going to ask you if you want to continue.
Alright, so play. Alright, and then in here, down trailer brake control, there should be two of them. Trailer brake control module. We know we want this one. We want it enabled. I think that'll turn it on, but we need to find where the gain is as well. There was two. Let's just turn the module on. So we'll write. Click OK. Please cycle ignition off and then back on. Off. Back on. All right. Are we good? Oh shit. Trailer disconnected, that's okay. We are disconnected, but when I hit that, it said gain for a second. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and start my truck. so the battery don't die on me. Alright. Gain. Holy shit. So we got gain. And then when I hit the trailer brakes, trailer disconnected. Cool, 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 cool. Okay. Alright, so now we're back here. I want to say, we want to go ahead and disconnect. Executing service procedure. Let me turn it back off. I think we're good. I'm gonna go ahead and pause it for a bit. Here, actually, let's just... This wants me to register. I'm just gonna leave that alone for now. Config modules. Still enabled. I'd love to like have it formally tell me we're disconnected. And I kind of want to save this log. I'm going to go ahead and do that. Let's see if that... I think like when it reads... Maybe like when it reads my codes the next time I plug in, I'll save that as like... I don't know, like base plus trailer brake enabled. So I can like keep track of everything I've done. I just wish it would let me like disconnect. I'm thinking about, like, 'cause it went through. Let me hit cancel this. Every time I hit cancel on this, like, register this device, it throws me errors. Like, you can't use it without registering. Huh. I'm gonna go ahead and save this as base... plus trailer brake enabled 2021. I'm the only one that uses this computer, so I'm not worried about like other people. I'm gonna go ahead and disconnect. And then, see what we got. Reconnect, and then, like, pull, like, the current codes and verify that trailer brake is still enabled. I'll go ahead and pause it for now. All right, we're back. I totally disconnected, and trailer brake still worked. I was able to change the gain. So let's go ahead and reconnect. Alright, so found recorded profiles for this or a similar vehicle. Would you like to load the selected vehicle? No. I want to pull exactly what's on here. Because I think if you pull the... if you pull the save profile, it's going to be like your base info. So I'm reading the current vehicle info. Man, I hope my battery don't die on the truck, not my phone. All right, so we will let that go. I got my trailer sitting over here. I'll hook it up too and see if the brakes engage. I'm curious too how like the towing settings look. Ignore my trailer name, Big Boy. So we'll see what that looks like. All right, still reading. We were in that IPC one. There it is right there. So I am curious. Would I like to save profile? No. All right, IPC. All right, come on, trailer brake. Trailer brake control module is enabled. Hell yeah. I read online some people had issues with like certain versions of this, but it was like March of last year. They were saying they had to like go back a version, and then I read too that you needed to do the trailer gain and the module. So I still need to research that, because even though it's telling me over here gain change, I need to make sure it's actually enabled. So we're gonna go ahead and disconnect from everything, load it to the trailer and see what happens. All right, I won't put you in the video. All right, we've already tested it and it works, but we're gonna go just test this one side once more. So hold on. All right, hit the brake pedal. All right, I hear a beep. Hit it again. All right, now hit the slider. All right, hit the slider. Do it again. Perfect. All right, I think we're good. All right, making a little video of this trailer brake controller install. There's gonna be a lot of cuts, pauses, whatnot. I'm really just doing this for reference. Not sure if it'll work, but I'll try to make it decently short. All right, so I got a 2021 XL STX 2.7 EcoBoost, and it's got, you know, a couple of those towing add-ons, but no towing package. Got the little coin tray here. So let's see what we got here. All right, so first part, this little module thing, and this should be all OEM, came from the dealership. $280 after taxes. So that'll go down there supposedly. I found a install guide from Ford. So I'll kind of loosely follow that. Not loosely, I'll follow that before we get into the craziness. All right, here's this bad boy. So supposedly we can just pull that little coin tray out, so let's see what happens. I think it should be finger tight, but I don't know. Might just pop it out real quick with that. Ooh, I don't know if that'll fit. Maybe get a little. There we go. Kind of work it out a little. Sweet. So we got a little cord here. I'm gonna pause it real quick. All right, and that just snapped in on the little coin thing. It was just a little placeholder. It just kind of came right out. Didn't really seem like it snapped in there. Video I'm looking at online shows plus and minus at the bottom. I'm gonna check the install.